So hi guys, welcome to our channel. So we are with a person who helps us during our hard times. So let's welcome Miss Neelam. Hi Neelam.
Hi.
Can you just tell me how is your lockdown going on? What are you doing right now?
So like others, lockdown is a stressful period definitely. You're being at home most of your time, doing all the chores, maids are not there. You are busy all the time, up and down. There are all of those things happening. So yeah. But I'm passing on, so there's not much I'm going through.
Okay. So can you just brief our audience what exactly psychologists do?
So psychologists are the people who look after, who are presented in the all fields of, you can see them in the organization, hospital, and all the certain field you can think of. So in the organization, a psychologist helping out the employees going through their issues, day-to-day life, work efficiency, emotional problems. But whereas, since I'm working in a hospital, I look after the cases related to depression, anxiety, regular day-to-day issues, which is creating a lot of pains and other stuff in the human body. So I help them in finding out issues related to it and help them to cure it. I also specialize in the career counseling, where the students come to us and ask us for the field they would like to choose, and how, if they are uncertain, they ask us to suggestions. So this is what my area of interest is.
Okay. So as you know, lockdown is going on. So what do you think this will affect the mental health of other people, like who are in quarantine?
So yes, Shipra, that's a very good thing you've asked. People are really going through anxiety. I receive a lot of frequent calls related to anxiety these days. People are anxious being at home. They've started doing a lot of things which is overthinking. Anger and domestic violence cases have increased. Mm-hmm. Over observation of the partners. They're less busy. They're stressed due to the financial constraint which has come, because a lot of people not getting their salaries. Mm-hmm. A lot of people have lost their jobs. So it is giving them a lot of stress and anxiety, which is causing a lot of domestic violence and the clinical anxieties as well.
Okay. So what all the cases what you are getting, the cases, what all cases you are getting?
So
right now,
the type of cases I'm getting are mostly anxiety, mm-hmm. anger outburst,
just because
losing interest in things like depression. Yeah. That's pretty obvious. I understand. Mm-hmm. Depression is turning very... So this is not the clinical depression, but the depressive features. Suicidal thoughts are very common these days, because everybody is at home. People are going through financial constraints, and a lot of people have gone through the job losses. Mm-hmm. They are living in a rental house. So I'm guessing a lot of cases related to anxiety, depression, suicidal thoughts. And the old people who already have disorders, they're already going through a lot of mental health issues. Those issues are aggravated. So I'm getting repetitive calls from the patients and the attendants who have had the history of such things.
So you deal with on-call, with your clients, on-call and everything?
So currently, yes. Since the due to corona, OPDs are not available. Mm-hmm. We are treating all the patients, all the counseling sessions are happening on video calls and audio calls.
So, do you have any advice for for balancing the work after the quarantine? Because it will be a hard time for other people after the work. They are in the house. They are being in a house for a long time and going outside and working in a.
The first thing which will come out, I think most of us are facing this, is the lethargy. Mm-hmm. Lethargy is the commonest we are feeling. None of us is getting up on time. To be very honest, everybody is late these days because nobody has to travel somewhere. Mm-hmm. Nobody is getting ready. They are mostly in their pajamas, sitting at home, chilling and working half of the day. So, the first thing I would tell, which is very, very much required, is the physical exercises. One has to do the physical exercise almost every day. Mm-hmm. It can be some power yoga. It is not that you have to really go for the run. It can be some power yoga, which will be helpful. It can be some basic abdominal exercise, some leg raising exercises, which will help them to cure the ease, so that once they go out of the home, they just don't feel lethargy, don't feel out of energy when they have to go back to work. Because as soon as they go back to work, the first thing which all of us will face is the lethargy.
So coming towards the next question, how can people deal with stress, anxiety and depression at their home during this period?
So it's completely up to their hands. So people are actually getting prone to more thinking, overthinking, I think. One has to avoid the topics which brings everybody, you, I and everyone knows which brings anger in your partner, in your family members. Avoid such situations, avoid such discussions, unless and until they're very necessary. Don't think about the old things which has happened and you cannot correct them. Avoid thinking about them. Do not reopen the bad chapters of your life or which create a lot of anxiety. Now the most anxious situation is for those people who are not getting salary. There is a big bunch of the people you will see who is not getting salary, they are financially in the crunch. So what is happening? Initially they overspent the money when they had it. Now this is the time companies have stopped giving the money. One has to manage the time. Everybody knows how much money they have in their pocket. Plan it accordingly because you don't know how long it is going to last. The quarantine and the self-isolation is how long it is going to last. To ease the financial anxieties, you have to take care of this thing. The second is most important, avoid overspending on things. Just because non-essential things have started, you know, getting into the sale, Amazon and other e-cart have started doing their businesses, people will start order unnecessary things. Avoid it. Then there is a lot of anxiety that we are at home doing nothing, we are bored. You can watch movies, TV series, you can read some good books available online. A lot of people who lost their job can look for the new job. Rather, they get anxious. Yeah, they can look for the new job. Making yourself busy in any X, Y, Z possible. Because if I say this line as straight as you said, keeping yourself busy, people will not understand it.
Yeah.
Everybody would misunderstand it. So it's better I explain that you one has to do something to keep themselves out of the anxiety.
So do cases increase during this? Like it's obvious.
They're very much vulnerable. Now the calls related to anxiety and self-quarantine, the people who are into self-quarantine, the cases have started coming and they're very vibrant. There are a lot of people undergoing a lot of things these days. Too much anxiety, too much overthinking. Yes, this lockdown and this thing have affected people's mental health. That is for sure.
So how is the lifestyle of a psychologist different from the other specialties?
The psychologists turn into counseling. Mm-hmm. Psychologists turn into solving the interpersonal issues. The other specialties are into medicine. So there is cardiology, there is psychiatry. So psychiatry, what do they do? They do counseling, but literally. But they do provide the medicines to the people. Psychologists are the people who undergo the counseling session, pick up each irrational ideas in the person's mind and deal with it and turn it into the rational. So that is how the therapists work and the other specialists deal with the medicines.
Okay. So now, not me taking much time. So the last question, what is your advice to the people for this lockdown?
This is the best advice I can give to the people is to focus on yourself, focus on your physical health. Physical exercises must. Then do not raise such topic which creates anxiety in you. Keep yourself most occupied. Keep yourself busy throughout the day and have a routine. Having a routine is the most important. Don't try to just get up and sleep on any random time. You have to have a routine where you're getting up on time, having breakfast, lunch, dinner and everything should be fixed. Otherwise, down the line, after the afternoon, you will be really sick, you will feel sad, you will be upset. Having a routine, having some of the office work, some of the household work, I think you will be going well with this. You can spend some time with the family, playing board games and all, but you can do some household chores also, explaining some cleanliness and anything, but one has to have keep themselves busy.
Yeah, as you can see, people are being creative these days and cooking
they
stuff.
Are creative, they are doing painting, cooking, what not, singing, dancing.
Exactly. So yeah, we can make ourselves busy through this stuff.
You can make yourself busy, definitely, yes.
So yeah, it was very nice meeting you.
Thank you so much for your time.
Hope we meet soon and yeah. Thanks for coming.
Yeah, great. Thank you so much for your time, Shipra. Bye.
Bye-bye.